Madam Chair, just a point, and not to belabor the conversation this evening, but I know that there were some who expressed both support and concern due to my recent participation. And I think it's really important that I continue to demonstrate who I am as a man, as an educator, as a leader, and someone who's focused on our school district. And I shared this with the board. I was very direct with the board as to who I am, my personality, because if you recall, I said I was interviewing you as much as you were interviewing me, and that you would never turn around and question whether or not the same individual who sits before you or operates our school district is the same individual you interviewed. You have two choices in this world. You can build bridges or you can build walls. And quite frankly, my position on certain topics is largely irrelevant. My position on all things is that all students will achieve and attain at a high level. Whether you agree with my participation in the critical race theory discussion, what needs to be reiterated here yet again was, my position simply was, if we tell our community we do not teach critical race theory, then they have every right in a community that over 50% of our students are minorities to question, then what exactly do you do to support children in our schools? That is my purpose. That is my focus. And so I'm sorry for those of you who are disappointed. Quite frankly, I would ask you to embrace the fact that I, in a very short period of time, am willing to take on very difficult conversations and topics, and I will not cower, I will not hide, and I will not run. It is important for us to address issues and come to consensus and understanding of each other's positions, our own frustrations, and how ultimately it impacts our school district. And so I'm proud of the fact that I stood there, and I'm proud of the fact, and thank you for everyone who spoke in favor, and thank you to those of you who shared concerns tonight, because it afforded me the opportunity to clarify my position on this. My position at the end of the day is how do we best support our students, and as we discussed, if you watched the workshop, I cited some of the very same data that I shared at that forum. We have a long way to go for all children in our community, all, and all does mean all. We have to create better opportunities for equity. We are a nation that's struggling. Let me limit it to gender instead of race to help exemplify what I'm talking about. We know that nationally we have fewer women going into STEM, engineering, and science professions. We have an obligation to encourage that to happen. And so at the end of the day, we will support all learners to the greatest extent possible and eliminate all barriers to their potential success. I will continue to emphasize and focus on those areas, and if that is not what Polk County Public Schools wants, then I will accept that. But that is my position on these topics. And I'm appreciative of all of our community partners who have extended an opportunity for me to come meet with them and talk about the hard topics, talking with each one of our municipalities about how frustrated they are, about how they feel like they've been left behind at times. They're frustrated about the lack of resources, the status and quality of their schools. You've heard staff share their frustrations with salaries. This is what I'm walking into 3.5 weeks on the job. And I am very much on the job and working hard, and I'm truly dedicated to solving as many of these issues as quickly as possible. And I have a strong, dedicated team around me, and I'm very much appreciative of the support from our board. Thank you, Madam Chair.